Chronic cholecystitis. The chronic cholecystitis is the most common disease of the gallbladder, and it is associated with gallstones in about 90% of the cases. The most common etiology are the gallstones. Then the chronic cholecystitis may also develop following recurrent attacks of acute cholecystitis. Let's see about the morphology of chronic cholecystitis. Grossly, the size of the gallbladder can range from normal size, or the gallbladder can be shrunken in severe cases due to fibrosis. Next, the serosa. The serosa is usually smooth, glistening, or it may be dull due to fibrosis. But the serosa is usually smooth and glistening. Coming to the cut section, the wall appears thickened, opaque and grayish white in color. Then the lumen. The lumen usually shows stones, that is the gallstones. So size is either normal in size or shrunken. Serosa is smooth and glistening usually. Cut section, the wall appears thickened, opaque and gray white, and the lumen usually shows stones. Next, the microscopy of chronic cholecystitis. In mild cases, there is only scanty inflammation, and the inflammatory infiltrate consists of lymphocytes, plasma cells, macrophages, which are present in the mucosa and the subserosa. But in case of advanced cases, there is marked subepithelial and serosal fibrosis with mononuclear cell infiltration. The mucosal epithelium may be normal or it can either be atrophic. Next, the characteristic feature of chronic cholecystitis is the presence of Rokitansky-Ashoff sinuses. The Rokitansky-Ashoff sinuses are irregularly shaped tubular structures which are formed due to invagination of the mucosal epithelium deep into the wall of the gallbladder. So the Rokitansky-Ashoff sinuses are irregularly shaped tubular structures which are formed due to the invagination of mucosal epithelium deep into the wall of gallbladder. Now let's see the different morphological variants of chronic cholecystitis. First is cholecystitis glandularis. So here the mucosal folds fuse together, form crypts of the epithelium buried in the gallbladder wall. This is cholecystitis glandularis. The next variant is porcelain gallbladder. So here in porcelain gallbladder, there is extensive dystrophic calcification within the gallbladder wall. So there is extensive dystrophic calcification. This is called as porcelain gallbladder. The third morphological variant is acute on chronic cholecystitis. As the name suggests, there is superimposition of acute inflammation on existing chronic inflammation. So, acute on chronic cholecystitis. And the fourth morphological variant is xanthogranulomatous cholecystitis. In this case, there is marked thickening of the wall and diffuse or nodular collections of macrophages containing neutral fat and lipofuscin pigment. So there is marked thickening of the wall and there is diffuse or nodular collections of macrophages, and these macrophages contain neutral fat and the lipofuscin pigment. These are the four morphological variants of chronic cholecystitis. Coming to the clinical features of chronic cholecystitis, there are recurrent attacks of steady or colicky type of epigastric pain or right upper quadrant pain. Also, there can be nausea, vomiting and fatty food intolerance. The clinical features include steady or colicky epigastric or right upper quadrant pain. Nausea, vomiting and fatty food intolerance may be present. Lastly, the complications of chronic cholecystitis. The complications include bacterial superinfection with cholangitis or sepsis, gallbladder perforation and formation of local abscess, gallbladder rupture with diffuse peritonitis, biliary enteric fistula, also called as cholecyst enteric fistula. There is a fistula formation between the bile duct and the intestine. So, biliary enteric fistula. So, this can result in gallstone induced intestinal obstruction causing ileus. Gallstone induced ileus. And the last complication is porcelain gallbladder has increased risk of cancer. So, the porcelain gallbladder can lead to cholangiocarcinoma. This is all about the chronic cholecystitis. Thank you.